there, everyone. It's Kathy, and welcome back here to my YouTube channel, Kathy's Random Acts of Stampin', and here in my craft room. I was looking for something that was maybe a little bit different to bring to y'all for today's video. So I went through my stamp sets, and this is one that I bought because I thought it was different. You have the vertical, it's called Vertical Blooms. So you have these vertical sentiments, and I like that. But what caught my attention was this cute little scrolly top part of a frame. So I'm going to use that as my focal point. This set of stamps does not come with a set of dies, so I'm pulling in another set, and that's my Countryside Corners. Now, if you have not taken a look at these, they are a great set of label dies. If you are looking for a really nice set that you can use for a variety of different sizes, shapes, whatever, this is definitely the one to get. I'm going to take this one out, and it is the 1, 2, 3, 4th one from the smallest, or third one from the largest, however you want to count it. But it's this one right here. And I'm going to take, this set is actually on page 104 in the catalog, the Vertical Blooms. And if you're looking for the Countryside dies, let me take you over to our dies, and I'll show you where those are at. You can buy these dies alone, or you can get them in a bundle. They're right here, and it shows the Countryside Corners. And of course, if you want to bundle it and get the stamps to go, the stamp that goes with it. And that stamp is just one large stamp, and then you can use those dies to cut out. Let me pull that, the stamp set. This is the stamp, and you can see it's just one big stamp. And you can take this stamp, and it will give you all these little dots and dashes and little flowers and petals and what have you. And then you can cut those out to frame your piece if you like. But we're not going to do that today, because we're going to let this little piece in here, this little scrolly thing, frame our frame for us. So I'm going to go ahead and cut this piece. And I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to use my trimmer. Let me put my catalog up so I don't make a mess out of it. Get it back over where it belongs. And then we're going to cut this piece of white cardstock. And this is a thick basic white. And I'm going to put this in. And what I do when I'm doing a die cut, I'll just kind of set it onto my piece of cardstock and get it, you know, so I'm not wasting my cardstock. And then I'll come over to about where I need it to cut. And I think 3 inches is going to be perfect. So I'm going to cut this off at 3 inches. And now we can use this piece and go ahead and die cut that. So I'm going to bring up my die cut machine. And we're going to sit this right about here. And I'm going to grab my plates. So for this one, I'm die cutting, so I need my number one base plate. I need my number two die cut adapter plate. And then I need my dedicated cut plate and my cover plate. So I'm going to lay this down on here. I want it to go in at a bit of an angle so it's not going in on a straight edge. It makes it go through the machine much easier. A lot less stress on the machine, your arm, and your plates. So we'll just crank that through like that. And then once we have that cut, put my plates back over here and get rid of our machine for a moment. Now we have this piece all cut out and ready to go. So the next thing I want to do is take out my stamp. And this is that little scrolly piece that we want. And see how it will fit so perfect on this particular die cut. So I'm going to straighten it up and kind of center it. It's not perfect, but it, you know, it's going to look great once we get it punched and stamped. So we've got it, not punched, I'm sorry, die cut and stamped. I'm going to bring in the We Are Memory Keepers Precision Press Advance. And if you are in the market for a stamp positioning tool. I highly recommend this one. It does slide around a little bit on my glass mat, but if I put something under it, like a piece of cardstock, it does have grippers on the bottom that will grip to that. I'll show you that. So if I put it on this, it's a little bit more sturdy or stable. You can also use like one of your cloths like this. And I think this is only if you have the glass mat, but it does make it a little more stable for you. So I'm gonna slide that all the way up into that top corner, getting it nice and straight against these pegs, just like that. And then I'm gonna position this onto my piece where I want it to stamp. Once I get that on there like I want it, I'm going to go ahead and put a magnet down here at the bottom just to kind of hold that in place for me. And then I'm going to set this onto my pegs and pick up my stamp just like that. And I'm going to ink this up, and I'm going to use some, because I'm not going to be doing any alcohol coloring on this, I'm going to use that VersaFine Onyx Black because it gives me such a rich black color. And this is a pigment ink rather than being a dye ink. So I'm just gonna ink that up. And I hear my dogs at the door. They're wanting in. they were outside. They were actually out with my husband. So he was home from work today. So they were out with him until they realized I was missing. So I may have to run to the door and let them in. And look how pretty that is. So now what I want to do is I want to clean this, and then we're going to turn it around and we're going to stamp it down on this end. Or what we could do, perfect positioning, just turn the cardstock around. That way we don't have to move our stamp. Put it up in that top corner just like we did. Much better idea. And we're just going to ink this up again. Just like that. And now we're ready to put this down and stamp it again. Right in that same spot, just line up your pegs and give it a press. Everybody needs a good positioning tool in their craft room. Well, I think they finally got in by themselves. One of them came in. I'm not sure about the other one. Toby may have stayed out there, but Bella definitely came in. So anyway, I'm going to clean the stamp really quick. And I'm just going to use a little bit of my Stampin' Mist stamp cleaner. This comes in a bottle like this. Excellent stamp cleaner. And I'm just going to spray some on my cloth and then take it to my stamp right here and clean that off. That's one thing with pigment ink, you're going to want to clean it off faster than your dye ink. Your dye inks are water-based and they are very easy to clean with just water. When you're doing anything with a pigment stamp, you probably need, or pigment ink, you probably need to clean that with some stamp cleaner. Okay. So now what I want to do is I want to bring out, there's a little scrolly piece in here that does the sides of these beautifully. So I'm going to position this about halfway between here and here. And see, it's tiny, but you can sit it down in there and get it where it's about the same amount of space between the one side and the other. About like that. Then we're going to pick that up. Of course, our piece came with it because that one's a little bit stickier because I haven't used it as much as I have this one. So we're going to do the same thing. We're going to turn this over and we're going to ink it. And then we're going to take our press and bring it back over and just give that a press right there. Isn't that gorgeous? And some stamps might work like that where you can do the reverse, but this one didn't seem to want to work for me. So we'll take it off and just pick it up and come back in. There we go. Now I did put a little bit of ink there, but hopefully when we ink this, it's going to cover it. So let's go in and ink. And with this press, how I always keep up where my stamp is, I always make sure my logo is in my left bottom corner. That way I know that I'm inking back up in the same place. So I'm going to press that. Ah, perfect. Isn't that gorgeous? Now you're able to stamp a sentiment or whatever you want in the middle of that. And you could do it this way or this way. So we can go vertical or we can go horizontal. I love the way that turned out. And we can find something, whatever we want, to put in the middle of that and just absolutely make that the focal point on our card. And that's exactly what I wanted to do with this set. I wanted to make it where it's our little focal point and just make it very, very pretty. So I'm going to go ahead and grab a piece of black cardstock because I want to position that with black. I'm going to move that piece of white out of my way. I don't want to get ink on that and mess it up. So I'm going to grab a piece of black cardstock. And I think this will work. And we can actually, if you want to, we can cut a frame the next size from this one. Oops. Not the stamp, the frames. So we could go up one more and grab the next bigger frame, which is this one. Let's cover the ink back up. An unopened ink is a recipe for disaster when I'm crafting. So let's grab this one. And I'm gonna anchor this down using a post-it flag. These are also in my affiliate links if you want to grab a set of those. They work great for holding your dies in place, and they're very gentle on your paper. So I'm going to bring this in and cut this down to about there. I don't need all of that, and that saves this much of my black paper without it having to run through the die cut machine. So let's go ahead, see how pretty this is going to be on here. That's going to give it a beautiful frame, and then we can put that on a piece of white cardstock, and it's going to be gorgeous. And this can actually be the front of your card very easily just by making a pretty center to go in the front. You can make very elegant cards in any color because you can stamp this whatever color coordinating cardstock that you want to make it in, which always makes for a beautiful card. That's why I say everyone needs a good die cut machine and some beautiful dies, because you can really step up your card making with just those items. So I'm going to bring out my plates again, same sandwich I used the first time, and I'm going to put this in, and again I'm going in at that little bit of an angle and crank that through. And see, we barely get a pop when you do it like that. If we went straight in on a straight edge, it would have cracked, it would have popped, and it would have probably curled our plates a little bit. And I work really hard to keep my plates nice and flat. See, that one's starting to where I can pounce on it just a little bit, and I got a little spring in it. So that's my indication it's time to turn that one over. This one I flip every time I use it. So that's how I keep my plates nice and straight without them curling up on me. So let's pull this off, and like I said, these come off really easy without tearing your paper. And I use these over and over. I use them until the sticky is completely gone. So let's put that one back there. And now we can go ahead, let's find out what sentiment we want to put in the middle of this. And I want to find something that has a get well type sentiment on it. This is hope and prayer, and this is a really nice one. Under his wing you will find refuge. I love that. Let's see if it will fit in there. It's too wide. Okay, we can't use that one. How about Hope Anchors Our Soul? We could do this one if we went this way. Oh, I like that. I think I'm going to use that one. And then I can always use this cross on the inside or the anchor. Hope Anchors Our Soul. I love that. So that's going to be my sentiment for this card. So I pulled in another stamp set that I wasn't really anticipating, but I think it's a good idea. So I'm going to put this right in the middle. Now you can stamp this with a colored ink if you like. I'm going to keep a white and black theme going with this because I think it looks very elegant. And I'm going to continue with my VersaFine ink because I love the way it stamps. I'm not going to use a stamp positioner for this. I'm just going to bring in a stamp block and pick that up, and I'm going to ink it. I always look at my stamp to see how well it's inked, and I also look for any ink that might have puddled around the edges, because if that happens, you want to wipe that off. So now I'm going to come in right to the middle like this and put Hope Anchors the Soul. Oh, that's so pretty. Look how gorgeous that is. And we can just pop this up on here just like that, and that'll be gorgeous. I love that. I think it's so pretty. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put some dimensionals on the back of this because I want this to pop off of the card just a little bit. So I'm going to, you know, I'm not stingy with my dimensionals. I want to put enough on here that will, the card won't fall apart in the mail. We know that the mail service is not what it used to be, so mail's not always handled with care. And so I just make sure that I get enough of dimensionals through here. I'll put one here, I'll put one right there, and maybe one more right about here. All right, I'm going to grab my Take Your Pick tool. I like to pick these off with my Take Your Pick tool. One thing, it pulls them off really nice and neatly. The other thing, it gets them all in a little pile where I don't have to have them all over my desk. And once I see they're all shiny, I know that the backers are all off. So now I can bring this over, and I do need that white sheet of paper again, because anytime you're gluing, you have a dark mat, or if you have a white mat, it doesn't matter. If you got any, you need something bright behind your black so you can see exactly where you're putting it. So this is going to go in something like that. And I'm going to give it a press, and so that's on there. So now we can grab, I want a piece of thick, and that's not my thick. I'm going to get a piece of thick, basic white. You know, this would make for a beautiful card. I wonder. I don't know. I think I'm going to go with my traditional. That was a card base that I already had made out of thick, but that's okay. We're going to go with our thick. Get this piece out of here. Here we go. The thick is usually so thick I have to feel to make sure that I'm not using two pieces. So what I want to do is I want to cut this in half. Because out of an 8.5 by 11, you can get two card bases. So if we're working with our A2 size cards, which is the standard measurement for a greeting card. So I'm gonna put it in on the 11 inch side, lining it up over here at 5.5. And I'm gonna slice up. And this gives us one card base. So this is 8.5 by 5.5, and we're gonna score it at 4.25. But I'm gonna bring up my scoring tool for that because I really like the way it scores better than my trimmer. Now the trimmer does have a scoring blade and I do use it from time to time. So I'm going to 4 1/4 and I'm going to give this a nice, very nice score line. Turn it over and then fold it back. Where that ridge is raised up, you want to fold into that ridge. That gives you a much even card base every time. And where is my bone fold? Here we go. So I'm going to go ahead and crease that down right here in the scoring tool. And you can always add more layers if you like. There's nothing that says we couldn't put another layer on here, but I think this is elegant just like it is. I think it's a very pretty card. Although, I am going to add another layer. I am going to put a layer that is 4 by 5 1/4 because I had an idea to dress this card up even a little bit more. So I'm going to put this in and cut it at 4 by 5 1/4. And then I need a piece of white. I don't know that that's going to be big enough. That's okay. We're going to cut a piece off of here and I'm going to cut this at 4 1/4. That's going to give me a half a sheet. And I am going to grab my dies that are called Darling Details. I love these dies. I love these little frilly pieces we have in the back. And I'm going to take that largest one and I'm going to lay it on here. But before I do that, I want to make sure that this piece will fit. And I think it will. So I'm going to cut this. We'll try it. And if it doesn't work, then oh well. I'll have a frilly piece for another card. So I decided when I came on today, I was just going to turn the camera on and just let it roll and see where we go. And that's exactly what I did. So I'm going to put that stamp over there so I don't get it on anything. And I do need to clean that one stamp. So let me grab my stamp and scrub. Love my stamp and scrub for cleaning my stamps. So I'm going to spray a little bit. You can activate this with water. And I'm just going to put a couple squirts down. And I'm going to bring this stamp over. Because remember, we did that with pigment ink. So I'm going to clean that off. Sorry about the squeak. And I'll clean. Love this. If you don't have a stamp and scrub, you need one. They are wonderful. And those little black pads come out. You can take them to your sink and clean them. And put them right back in and you're good to go. So it's a great tool to have, and if you take care of it, it will last you a lifetime. So let's grab our die cut machine again. And our pads, our cutting plates. Same sandwich again. And again, I'm going to go in at an angle because this is a very straight edge on this. So I'm going to crank this through twice because it is a detailed die. And when I say a detailed die, it has a lot of little filaments and holes and where the little flowers are. So all I did was cranked it through and cranked it back. So let's see what we got. Oh, it's so pretty. So what we're going to do with this, after we get all of our little pieces out, we're going to actually trim this down to go on the front of this. So I'm going to take that to my trimmer as soon as I kind of pop away all of my little pieces. And we can do that in a variety of ways. We can just come in with our take your pick tool and poke all of those little flowers out. All right, so now that we've got those all out, I'm just gonna go ahead and brush off my cut plate. And yes, I got a little mess on my desk, but that's okay. I wanna make sure I get those all off of my plate so that the next time I use it, I don't have anything sticking on there. So here we go, we got our plates back together. And you're probably thinking, oh my goodness, what are you gonna do with that mess? Well, have you met my ladybug? You have seen me use this many times. This is my little dust stack. And there's also an Amazon link for this if you'd like to get one. Look how easy it makes the cleanup of any of your little dye pieces or scraps of paper or what have you. Just really takes care of all that debris. And I love this thing. And it empties really easy. It just runs on a AA battery. Wonderful. All right, so let's bring out our trimmer and I'm gonna show you how I'm gonna trim down this piece. I've got about, I would say about 1/8 of an inch, maybe 1/4 of an inch. So I'm gonna try to do 1/4 of an inch all the way around. And my dogs are snoring up a storm, y'all. So I cut that off, that looks pretty good. So now I'm gonna line it up here and do the same thing. Just want that 1/4 of an inch. And I'm kind of looking at this line and lining it up right there with that 1/4 inch mark. Just like that. And then I'm gonna come down here and this looks pretty good. I think I need just a hair back off of this one. Just a tiny bit. Yep, that was good. And then we need just about that same amount off of this piece. Maybe about 1/16 of an inch. Something like that. Now we can come back with our card base, and see what we have. So now if we glue this down on here, something like that, and set this on it, something like that. Oh, isn't that pretty? Love it. And then we can put the whole thing on a white card base like that. So of course it won't be crooked, and hopefully when we get everything glued down. So I'm gonna start with this, and I'm gonna use liquid glue because I just want to make sure I'm getting glue on these outside edges. Something like that. And over here like this. And then we're gonna turn this around. And again, I probably need that white piece of paper to put under here. Let's see, maybe we can do it on this. Yeah, that'll work. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna bring it over to the edges like that. And then pull it over just a little bit. And I'm gonna give it a press. Just like that. And that's pretty all by itself. And then, really I wish I hadn't put this on because then that would have fit right into the middle of that. Let's see. Let's see if we can get this taken care of. We might be able to pull this up. So just like that. We want to try to do it without bending it. I didn't think this through. I would have waited to do this. But like I said, I came and I did this with all of you. And I'm just kind of creating on the fly. And when you create on the fly, sometimes you make changes in midstream. And I definitely did that. What I might do after we get this off. Not bad. I think we can make that work. Look how pretty that's going to look sitting right in between there. So I'm going to see if I can pull these all off of the back. And they're coming off pretty good. And we'll just pop some more down where these were. I make these mistakes so when you get ready to make a card like this, you don't have to. You can just follow my instructions instead of my mistakes. Hopefully that will work for you. So pulling these all off, try to clean up the back of this card as best we can, or this die cut piece. I'm going to use my little spatula and see if that won't get them off a little bit better. This is actually a spatula for my Cricut. You can see it says Cricut right there. But I use this, I keep it on my desk because I use it in my card making for so many things. And if I cut something with my Cricut, I bring it back over here to put it together. So I still need it here at my desk. And it's just a great little tool to have. And I'll look and see if these are on Amazon. If they are, I'll link it. So in case you want to pick one up, you can just go to my link and click on it, and it'll take you directly to the item. All right, I think we did a decent job with that. So now we can sit this down like that. I am going to put some more dimensions on it, and I'm going to get any debris that's on this piece off. And dimensionals. I'm going to go here, and here, and here, and here. Again, there, and there, and there, and there. And then we only need two more. Here and here. So now we're going to do this little number again. Take these all off. Just like that. And then we're going to set this down right in the middle as best we can. And then we're just going to turn this around. Excuse Bella, she's down here snoring as usual. I let my glue sit there long enough that I got a clump in it. So I'm just going to pop it with the pen and hope that that will take care of it. And I think it has. And we're just going to go ahead and add some glue to the back of this. And then set this down. Don't y'all just love a black and white card? I think they're so pretty. All right, for my inside, I'm gonna put a black mat. This will make a card base, but you know what? We're gonna use that and cut us a piece that will go in here. So I'm gonna cut this in half, or not in half, I'm gonna cut it at four. just like that. Then I'm going to turn it around and cut it at 5 1/4. All the measurements will be on the blog post, along with all the items that I used to make this. We need to cut one more piece of white. And we need this one to be 3 3/4. About 5. And I need to get, well, I'm going to stamp on here with the anchor. I think that would be beautiful with the sentiment, hope anchors the soul. And we're going to put that there. We're going to put a get well in the middle. So let me find a get well sentiment and I will be right back. Let's see if we got one. All right, I'm back and I found this stamp set that's called Through It Together. And this has some very good sentiments that you can put together. It does have a get well soon, which I am going to use. I'm going to put at the top, praying for blankets of healing around you. And where it says, and yours, I'm going to mask that off, because I want it to say around you, get well soon, sending you this paper hug. So I'm going to take 3 stamps out of that set and try to form it into one. So what I want to do is I want to mask off right here where it says, and yours. So I'm going to take one of my little post-it flags and I'm going to tape it right over top of the and yours. Just like that, so that when I ink that up, that will be covered. And let me show you how we're going to do that. I'm going to take a stamp block and pick this up. And then I'm going to ink it up. Just like that. Then I'm going to pull that off, throw that in the trash, and then we're going to bring it up right here at the top and stamp. And then I'm going to take the get well soon and load it up on a block. And I'm going to ink it and put that one right here. And then I'm going to put right up under it, sending you this paper hug. And I'll grab another block. And put this one right here. Then I'm going to take my anchor and ink it up and put it right there. And then all we have to do is put our black mat we can put this on here like that. And I think for this, I'm going to use some Stampin' Seal. We can go ahead and line this up on here, just like that, and then we can put this inside like this, and I'm going to use glue for this. can sit this right inside of our card. And I think this would make anyone feel better. At least I hope it would. So there is our thank you card, or not our thank you card, but a get well card for today. I love that because hope does anchor the soul. I hope you've enjoyed the tutorial of me making this. Remember, all of our products and everything is listed in the PDF tutorial, and you can get that on my blog. The links are down below this video, and if you see any of the products that I use today and you want to pick those up, please click my link that says shop here or shop with me now, or if you want it on the PDF tutorial, it will be a place there for you to click on the link. And on that tutorial, you will find picture of the card. You will find the PDF tutorial. You will find the video. That's all on the blog. So everything that you need will be there. So I think it's a great place to go for all the information about everything I do. So be sure to check out my blog. Thanks so much. God bless and keep you. And as I always say in closing, let everything that you do or say bring glory to Jesus. God bless and keep you. I love you guys so much. And until next time, bye-bye.